Wow, it has been a while, but I got plenty of reasons why, and I want to tell you that, yeah, I did it. I sold my A7 III. Oh, new merch, come on, check that out. Isn't that awesome? Back to the Future is the best movie of all time. What's up, guys? If you're new here, my name is Paul, and I run a channel that inspires other creators that your future is whatever you make it, and I do that through gear reviews, tutorials, and today we're going over this new setup that I just switched to, the A7C. It has been game changer for me as far as creating content, and I can finally start creating content. Sorry, it's been a while due to that, but if you like stuff like this, if you like gear reviews, hit that subscribe button, that like button, it really helps me out. And go check out the new Paul Feinberg merch, get you some new stuff if that's what you're into. I switched to this A7C, and I gotta tell you that I've been fairly impressed, because everybody always says, oh, it's just a mini A7 III, chop off the viewfinder, put it in an APS-C body, and this is the camera. And to a certain degree, yes, but this camera offers some new features that should be in every single one of the cameras moving forward, which it will be because it's Sony. But the thing that makes this thing so much better is, one, the flip-out screen. What have I said in my previous videos? If the A7 III had a flip-out screen, it'd be pretty much the perfect camera. And this thing has it. It's very similar to an A7 III with a flip-out screen. For a photographer, I love the fact that it's a flip-out screen. I can kind of angle that thing really low and still have that screen flipping out. Like, see, I can lay it straight on the ground and just look down and have the screen flipped out. I mean, it's game changer. It's so good. I'm sorry. I think that this is the way to go in the future. It's got the new color science, which is under, everybody's always like, it's an A7 III in a new body. I mean, it's not exactly the truth, because this thing has got new colors. It's not the same A7 III colors. It's new colors. It looks even better and more crispy and just beautiful. I think the color science is amazing. They took the very similar color science of the A7 S3 and the ZV-1 and threw it in. I just think the colors just do a better job of rendering straight out of camera. Does it have S-Cinetone like the A7 S3? No, but it's pretty darn good. And the other thing that's overlooked is the autofocus. The autofocus on the A7 III is good. Don't get me wrong, that camera is great. But holy cow, is it on a whole new level with this A7C, ZV-1, A7 S3. They got this like tracking autofocus that is just so cool. It gets the eye, like right now I can see that it's getting me because it's got like the eye, the little box around my eye. Just phenomenal. You can't go wrong with this setup. What are people thinking? It's not an A7 III. It's not an A7 III. But it is got all the best qualities of an A7 III. This thing is great. If you are coming from an A6600, if you're coming from any APS-C line, and even if you want a little bit of a bump up and you're on the A7 III, I think it is a good upgrade, given that you can deal with these few caveats that I'm gonna go into. The biggest thing that stinks about this camera over under the A7 S3, and why most people say if you're a photographer, stick with the A7 III, you're trading off custom buttons essentially for a little bit better features, and it sucks. It does. I miss out on a lot of those custom buttons, but I've got custom button settings that I think is gonna work really well and will make it workable for video and photography. So, like I said, subscribe for more of those videos. They will be coming in the future. The only thing this thing doesn't have, those darn menus, man. Doesn't get the new touch menu where you can actually use the touch screen, but the fact that it flips out is perfectly fine with me. And as an A7 III, A6600, all those users, I'm used to the menus, so it's perfectly fine for me. And once I set this thing up, I don't really go into the menus a whole ton. You'll want to check out future videos. I'll be doing a settings video, how I set this A7 C up, and I'll be doing a bunch of quick tip type of videos, quick setup tips, as time goes out. I think this camera is a perfect content creator's camera, and it shouldn't be overlooked. And people that can't afford to get the A7S III, or they don't want to spend the money on the A7S III, and you're a content creator, this camera should not be overlooked at all. I would jump on it in a heartbeat. Who knows when the A7 IV will come out, and the price tag will be still more expensive than this, and it probably will still do more things than the average, just put it on a tripod, get your videos starting, and you'll get that nice lens selection of the full frame cameras, that nice bokeh that you can achieve still, and get all the benefits of that full frame sensor in the small body, like the APS-C size. So I can't speak enough of it. That's why I've been on a delay. I sold all my cameras. Tip, never sell your camera, your main camera at least. Purchase the new one, then sell your old stuff, if you can do that, because I could have done that. I already had buyers lined up, and I was like, well, I don't want to miss out on these buyers, and now I've been cameraless for like 2 months, because darn FedEx took forever to deliver this A7C. If people saw me on Twitter, like Original Dobo, you would know it was not pretty. But anyway, this camera is so good. So good. I'm doing more content like this in the future, so if you aren't already, subscribe. This camera is well worth the upgrade over the A7 III just for these little features. I hope you guys enjoyed this one. It's a just really quick, brief video to get out there to my main peoples, just to let you know what's going on and all the stuff to expect in the future. Hey, you know what? Go out there, get the merch, go out there and get the merch, and you know that I will see you in the future.